attacked you, and I haven't.
What does that mean?
Rise.
When Gotham is ashes, you have my permission to die.
This is Charles Howard. He is on his way to riches, but for now, all he has is 3 cigarettes, 21 cents, and a promise to his wife that he will send for her soon. He is headed for San Francisco.
Any spare dime, sir?
Sure. Why would a swell man like yourself need money? You're swell and look quite well.
Dreams. Thanks, sir.
You're welcome.
Spare dime, sir?
Beat it, fool!
Dreams. Dreams, dreams, dreams. Dreams, 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 dreams. All I need is dreams.
Golly, I got a box shop now!
No one can meddle with my plans to open a bike shop. Not even Charles Howard. If I can't have said bike shop that he just opens, then I may just have to bully him out of it. Looks like my only chance is to beat him in combat, but it will take a lot of training so that I can be in peak physical shape to beat up Charles Howard. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you?
Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Don't let her be.
Sorry.
Oh, okay. Oh.
I need to assemble a team.
Wanna get beat up?
I don't wanna fight. No. I need you though, for my EGT.
What's that?
Elite Greaser Team.
Hey, you!
Join my Greaser Team.
Need to get tased.
You must join the team, or else you'll die.
Smile with your neck, fool.
Join my team, I'll give you a second degree burn.
Automobiles, that's where the real money is. But the cops are against it. There's laws.
I heard them moving buggies can't even move up hills.
You won't be saying that when I'm a billionaire.
Whatever you say, loser.
Charles had quite the journey, but finally in 1905, he had San Francisco's only Buick franchise. He started with only three Buicks and sold none of them. And in 1906, a huge earthquake happened, leaving the city in need for cars. He drove them to help the people of San Francisco, using them as ambulances. In 1908, Howard sold 85 cars at $1,000 each. Soon enough, he was super loaded, and by super loaded, I mean rich. I'm talking Uncle Scrooge rich.
I'm rich. Yes, rich.
How? How rich?
Extremely rich.
How? Extremely rich.
You can afford an iPhone of thousands, you...
Could you buy a car? Only 10,000 cars or so. Could you build a Death Star?
Absolutely not. Yeah.
Between you and Biggie, it was like, who's gonna... Charles thought he had everything. A healthy family, lots of money, a business. But he was wrong, because his son was killed by a truck when heading back from fishing. He named the hospital.
We had to go dress to change our description. Two cops is on the milk box missing. Show they clothes, you know they got stepped on. A fist full of bullets, a chest full of Teflon. Run from the police, picture that.
Censored. Censored.
That's why I bust back.
He died. That very young. Too young. I loved him.
We loved you.
We loved each other. I remember last month, you know, before he died, he said, Dad, I am going to be the first man to pass the stars. I guess he was right. He is beyond the stars now.
He
was too young.
He was too young.
I was going to be the one driving that day, but yeah. I stayed home. Yeah, I was in my chair eating pudding while my son got squished in a car. It's just... No.
No.
I'm sorry. He was.
Don't hit me.
I'll miss you.
After all these years, the greasers were still mad about the bike shop scenario. Finally decided to do something about it. They went into a dark alley and ambushed Charlie in the middle of the night. Censored.
I'm gonna shank you with my comb.
You're gonna die, freak.
Yeah.
Turn. Girls never did see that mysterious hero ever again. Things were very shaky in the Howard house, and the second he got home from the dramatic greaser battle that just took place, his wife decided to divorce him.
What?
Divorce!
What, honey squiz?
No, Charlie, I'm taking you to court!
That's a load of horse!
My son's dead! Just fixing my body!
Censored.
My ugly!
Censored.
$1,000? You want me to spare you one of your teeth?
Oh, it's mine!
It's mine!
Hey,
now!
You wish my son's dead!
Next wedding, and she gets three-fourths of all your current income and your income for the next 13 years, and you can only see your kids on your wife's vacation. I hate that! Which is not on your short-term. You need to find a new house and car.
Oh, what a nice young lady! Why do you have any plans? Oh, you want to get a big sausage pizza?
Censored. Censored.
It's not pizza!
What? Hey, you're my son's wife. Anyways, babe, how's it going?
Swell, because it's worse.
I know you're my son's wife's sister. She gotta marry me.
Yes, yes, a million times yes.
Hey, this is great!
Yes, it looked like everything was going well in Charlie's life, aside from the divorce and such. He finally decided to live out his dream and build a racetrack with help from his pal, Bing Crosby.
I'ma tell you what, Charlie. I'll help you out because you're a friend. He has a whole bunch of money.
1935, Charles went looking for some good racehorses. And when he was looking, he found poor horse trainer, Tom Smith.
Well, what do we have here?
Didn't you hear about me?
But my friends call me Coach.
Well, monsieur, I want you to train my horses to become masterful.
Two questions. How much money do I make?
Where are the ponies?
Well, is this enough for you?
I want double.
Double? This?
Your dog. Bark, bark. Bark, bark indeed, my friend. Bark, bark indeed. The dog's about to bite.
Now with Mr. Smith's newfound riches, he could afford to have a fresh new getup. He decided to start wearing a sweet fedora and much nicer clothes. On top of that, he had a fresh cut, straight out the salon. He was what you'd call a class symbol, and he played it with honor and swag. On top of that, he was betting and winning stacks of dough. I mean money, like mad money. Tom went searching for horses, and on the way he met Seabiscuit. But he didn't get him. Not yet. Seabiscuit. Oh, hey, I didn't see you there. I was busy thinking about Seabiscuit and his dramatic career that was studded in American stardom. He was so dramatic and he was so famous, he had a movie with Shirley Temple, and another one with Tobey Maguire, who in The Great Gatsby co-starred with my favorite actor on the planet, Leonardo DiCaprio, for his awesome roles in Titanic. I'm Connor Hobson, and this is Seabiscuit's Family Hair, a mini documentary and a semi-musical. Seabiscuit was just one in a family of all this information was taken from Wikipedia and is most likely. If so, Seabiscuit's ancestors were often racehorses, meaning they raced a lot in races. They also bred a lot of other horses, and that's why there were a lot of horses in his family. As I just said, his family tree was studded with winners. He was from the Godolphin Arabian bloodline and started in Syria. These suckers date back to 1704. One of the early ones was Selma, the eldest in the line. But you could say the real winners started with... He was something called a British thoroughbred horse. In his career, he only ran 10 races. That's 90%. His son named Australian was a real loser and doesn't even have a Wikipedia article. His son Hastings was also pretty much a loser. He had a Wikipedia page, but
Next came Fair Play. He's best known for his great sires, which are his babies. Man of War is a true champion and deserves all the fame that Seabiscuit gets. He ran 21 races and won 20 of them. That's like 95%. His children include Clyde Van Dossen, the winner of the 1929 Kentucky Derby. Battleship, who was the only horse to have won both the American Steeplechase. And finally, Hard Track, who fathered Seabiscuit. Was a runt. On top of that, when Mr. Fitzsimmons said, Seabiscuit was often described that all changed one day when they paired Seabiscuit against Foss, the fastest horse in the stable, and Seabiscuit smoked him. Unfortunately, those results were short-lived, as Fitzsimmons soon realized Seabiscuit was lazy, easy.
Seabiscuit, you have shown your full potential, and that's why I'm gonna whip you into shape. You're gonna be a star! If I whip it hard enough, you go for it!
And they're off. What a great start.
I told my mom, tears rushing down my face. She's like, Ben, you've loved girls since before pre-K.
Looks like they cleared the first lap. Yeah, like it was just nothing. Bunch of stereotypes all in my Looks like Seabiscuit and Edgy McGoth are behind by a couple strides. A preconceived idea of what it all meant for those that like the same sex. My gosh. The characteristics, the right Edgy McGoth is catching up. And you can be cured with some treatment and religion. Oh my god, Edgy McGoth, he came in from the side. Oh my god, he's winning. And he wins it all. Seabiscuit's in fourth place.
Seabiscuit, you piece of garbage! Seabiscuit is a failure and such does not belong in my prestigious staple. He will be fooled for the sum of $2,500.
Get in here! Yes,
sir! Yes! Do you hear who won horsey?
Yes, Master Greenberg! Yes, Eagle!
I would think hip hop hates me. Have you read the YouTube comments lately?
Well, I watch out the loser horses on my stable, like Seabiscuit. Yeah, we don't have except egg room for.
I'm not getting
champions.
This is after me, over camera office.
Going
into
slap frenzy!
I bet you're cheating better that there's Seabiscuit guy that's gonna lose this race, Jones.
Okay, guys.
Thank you.
you get me some Faygo, darling?
I got that.
Sweetie.
I lost. Come back. Here it is.
Operator, pull me to Mr. Smith. Smith.
Hey, hold on, just a moment.
Hello, man.
Hey, how's it going?
You know, just kicking, man. What's up?
Dude, your brother, I feel you.
So what you calling about?
You look at a horse, it seems fine, you dig?
Yeah, man, you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Here's your lemonade, yeah?
Thanks, Twix.
What'd you just say, man?
I'm just the doll, babe.
Oh, okay, man.
I'll talk to him. Have it, brother. It should be all good, you hear me?
The day Charles Howard bought Seabiscuit.
See you next time.
You almost bet a boss.
You think so? Do you think so?
Kneel before me.
I'm sorry, boss. I'm sorry, boss. I'm sorry, boss.
I want a horse. Build him stronger, faster, and bigger than Seabiscuit.
This is Red Pollard. Genuine failure. Failing as a jockey and a prize fighter. whose career began to go downhill because he's a loser and went blind in one eye. Whenever he's near a mirror, he feels like it's important to slick his hair back. He's also a bum and lives on the side of the road. All he brings in his pocket are Shakespeare books and his saddle. He started to ride when he was ditched by his whole family. He did it for circuses and such, and he was pretty bad, so he also boxed as the Cougar. He also had a riding job. Not like normal bad, like Michael Jackson bad. He also was said to have smacked riders in the face with his whip when they cheesed him off. Then he'd admit it because he's cool. Yeah, him and Red were genuine lads.
Name, ho!
Hi?
I'm the new lady.
Okay.
Ooh! Sorry, I have allergies. No. My name's Toad.
Ready to go, Toad?
Not yet. Just gotta make sure we're safe. Just press this button. Just making sure all this is on, you know. Turn on the radio.
Items limited to one per customer. Emergency.
Change the sound settings. Go to radio, and click this one. Alright, we're ready to go. Get back out of here. Great. It's time to go. Alright, I'm driving. Aw, shucks. And we're gonna have to hitchhike. Find a car. Not that one. No. Yeah, that one. Thanks for the ride. Thanks for the ride. You gotta close your door. Please close your door. It's okay. We gotta go straight. We gotta go straight. Alright. Thanks for the ride, mister. My name's Toad. You're the greatest. Love you. Sweet burnout. But be careful. It's okay, he's fine. Your driving skills are unmatched. We're almost to the fairgrounds, Red. Don't worry, Red, we're almost to the fairgrounds. Police are after. Look out! Sorry. Just head straight to the fairgrounds. Yeah, you turn left here. Wait, no, that was right. Alright, here we are. Here's the fairgrounds. Thanks for the ride, mister. It took a little bit of searching, but eventually Toad found Red, his guy. His name was Tom Smith, also known as Seabiscuit's trainer.
How much dollar do you want for my jacket?
What do you mean?
How much dollar? How much money? I need money.
I'll write it on my hand.
Double it.
$16?
Buck, buck.
Thanks to the toad, Red finally had a good gig with the Seabiscuit.
Red, are you ready for your big ride today?
Then why would I be here?
I guess not.
That's what you guessed. You guessed right. Seabiscuit isn't a lost cause, but you need to train him and do it right.
Looks like I found the right jockey.
Seabiscuit began his dramatic training. At first he had a hard time flinging trainers off and such, and scraping the edge of the running trail. But eventually he got better.
Hey boy, what is it? Let me see it. Bigger, stronger, and more better than that pathetic sea.
What's his name, boss?
We'll call him D-biscuit. It's Death Biscuit. Shortened.
This race is very close. Seabiscuit's behind Myrtlewood. Oh, Myrtlewood is in the lead. Myrtlewood looks like she's gonna win. Seabiscuit stumbled a little bit there. He's still in this. And let's see on the track, they're coming around. Looks like Myrtlewood's still in the lead. And Myrtlewood wins it all. Yeah. It's in the mighty hands of steel when you're standing your ground. And you never give in when your back's to the wall. Gonna fight to the end and you're taking it all. You got the touch. You got the power. They're going around the track. It's down to Professor Paul and Seabiscuit. You'll be right. Going rapid speed, almost to that of an automobile, a fancy moving buggy. Looks like Professor Paul in first, Seabiscuit gaining. Slipping by, going for the win. Oh my god, he won it all. Tom Smith was quite excited to show off Seabiscuit the 100 grand. Before the race, Seabiscuit pulled off a practice mile of 1 minute 36 seconds. So that defeated the track record by 2 seconds. In a later practice run, he tied the 30-year-old 7/8 a mile run world record. And the gates are open and they're off. Doing pretty good, leading the pack. Oh no, one of the losers fumbling a little bit. Alright, he's already back. Quite the race. Going for some fast speeds.
Oh my god. My god, they're gonna break a track record. This is impressive. It's impressive. Going for the win now. Seabiscuit's pressing hard. He's pressing hard. He's going for the win. He's going for the win. It's a close one. Oh man, look at that. Seabiscuit's winning. Oh my gosh. He's going all the way around the track. Winning the race. And he's won it all. He just won it. Right there. Right when he passed that podium. That was the win. He's won it all. Skip began winning a ton of races and making a ton of money. For many people, it's hard to believe.
Splendid, splendid, Silvers. Yes, as Lee Tracy says, now we're in the money.
Hey, that's a nice way you got in that cue, Chester.
Oh, thanks, Ed.
Seabiscuit's going for the win. He's headed up. Headed up the lines. He's right there. Right there up front. Way ahead of everyone else. Just destroying the competition. No other way to put it. He's coming up front. Going for a full-on run. First person. Very impressive. You can only imagine what Red Bull is thinking right now. What a great racehorse, indeed.
What do you think about the recent race?
I think we're doing great. We are definitely dominating the West Coast.
What about the East Coast?
Well, not to give anything away, but I think their butts are toasted.
What do you mean by it?
Well, on the level of microwave oven to Turkish bath, I would have to go with Turkish bath.
Big talk for a little man.
Being small is a big part for a jockey.
What about horses like Rosemount?
Rosemount's a dick face.
War animal.
I've heard of him, but I got him in my bag. No comment! No comment! Go my first!
I want your comment!
I'm coming, boss! I'm coming!
Have you seen the news?
Yes, they're scared.
Yeah, boss! Boss!
We'll beat them, and then we'll get our own bike shop.
Is that the bike news, boss? Are we gonna do this?
Although D-biscuit was a clear threat, another clear threat to the team was War Admiral, the son of Man of War, a.k.a. Great Horse, a.k.a. Seabiscuit's grandfather. War Admiral was just like his dad, and also a super winner. War Admiral got the Triple Crown. Everyone's in the crowd today, 20,000 fans crowded for the ultimate rematch, Seabiscuit versus Rosemount for a second time, and they're off. There they go, Seabiscuit and Rosemount, of course. Rosemount, and Seabiscuit had the close race last time, but Rosemount came ahead. It's very hard to tell which horse is winning, as they are all very similar looking, because they're all horses. As you can see, there's a there's a bit of a traffic jam going on back there in the loser's circle. You can see him going around now. Loser's circle kind of catching up. Back has some distance on him, though. You can, of course, see the winner in first. Annihilating. This is Seabiscuit and Rosemount going for the win here. If there's any two horses that should race each other, this might not be the combination, but it sure will be an epic race. They're coming around. This looks like a close race. They're neck and neck, but it looks like it's going to be Seabiscuit. Seabiscuit again. Unlike last time, I should say. And there you go. Seabiscuit won it. Rosemount's a failure loser face. Charles Howard got a new stallion, a female stallion named Fair Nitrous, that he added to the barn and eventually wanted Seabiscuit and her to make babies.
Do you think Seabiscuit has to meet War Admiral?
Now I'm gonna stop you right there, Cal. The simple answer to that statement is yes.
Other news, they haven't found the last.
Meanwhile, Charles decided to meet up with Riddle and try and make their two horses meet in an ultimate race.
Nice try, fool.
Deal off then. See you next time, loser.
You suck. You're a horrible racer.
You wanna fight?
You wanna throw down, bro? You wanna have a bro down?
Throw down?
You wanna throw down?
You wanna throw down?
Well, not today.
No. However, even though their negotiations didn't work out, it just happens that they happened to be put together in three different races, so that worked out in the end. However, at one of their races, they happen to see a familiar face, familiar young sailor from earlier in Seabiscuit's lifetime. You may know him as Mr. Fitzsimons.
I am Fitzsimons! I would like to bring Seabiscuit my own horse!
I guess, yeah.
I would never do anything to you, Seabiscuit, boy!
Boy!
boy. Oh, I would never do anything the bad people do, boy. Oh, boy. Boy.
Ego! Hand me my gun! Ego! Where's my gold, Ego?
Ah, oh, it's safe.
Fix your hand! Set up an ad on the billboard.
What, master?
A horse trainer! You dumb brain!
Master, have you seen the ad? No, bring it here.
Here, it's about Fitzsimons.
This is intriguing. Like Seabiscuit's former trainer?
The one in the same!
Interesting. Bring him to me.
Dramatic Seabiscuit War Admiral race. Very familiar race to before. They're running through. It's a little muddy out, so Seabiscuit is a little farther behind than War Admiral, staying in the middle of the pack. War Admiral's keeping a strong, strong lead over Seabiscuit. He's going. Seabiscuit is being stubborn due to the deep mud that is happening currently. The deep mud that is happening currently. That is what I said, because of the rain. Negative weather does not make Seabiscuit a happy horse, and it seems that it is costing him today, as he is currently in 8th place. The crowd is aroused by War Admiral's strength, and intrigued by the failure that is Seabiscuit. This is not the 1937 handicap. This is, we filmed over the 1937 handicap. That is why you were seeing that. War Admiral won it, and Seabiscuit's in 8th. Yeah, he's a failure.
Now you gotta do it. Unless you're losing cheese face.
I have a cheese face? No, I'm still not gonna do it anyways.
If you don't do it, then you're a loser, butt face, cheese, dirty licker.
You think I'm a dirty licker?
You lick moldy cheese, you loser face.
You think I like You know how much my billions of dollars lick cheese? You know how much my millions of horses eat cheese?
Your butt. 1v1 me, baby doll. Tomorrow?
we'll figure something out. Yeah, but
deal.
Probably not.
Deal.
See you Monday.
Red Pollard's luck ran out. One day he fell off his horse while he was training her.
His injuries are serious!
Oh, my arm! I don't think I'll ever be able to race again.
Oh no! If he broke his arm and legs, how will we make me more money? No!
Fortunately enough, Charles was only suspended for a few races and wasn't suspended that long, as he wasn't actually injured that bad. It was just a few days later, though, after he was unsuspended, that Fair Nitrous fell on him on the track, and he was injured. For real this time.
You're gonna make it, pal.
Yeah, pal, you'll be great.
And your legs will heal too.
It hurts. I'm the toad. Your legs probably aren't gonna heal, kid. I'm looking for a new person, a new client. I'm gonna join the Greases. That's all I wanted to say.
Toad, you get out of here now!
I love
Tell Seabiscuit that I love him.
What about the funeral? It'll be okay.
Not yet. What about Seabiscuit?
Oh, he'll run, even if your lifeless body is riding him.
How about...
about who?
How about who?
Woods.
Wolf.
George Wolf. George Wolf.
This workman character. Go.
Too bad.
And we're back with another fantastic race, and they're off. Workman is now on Seabiscuit, as the previous rider, Red Pollard, was terribly injured. This is a great race. Seabiscuit's in fourth. Move down to fifth. Going around. On the track. Looks like he moved down. Oh no, he's still in fifth. Good horse with a lot of potential, but no bananas. No bananas on this race. Looks like we have Edgy McGough in the lead right now. They're in the home stretch. This is it. Seabiscuit near the end of the pack. And they're in. Seabiscuit was in fourth and is in fact, and did in fact lose this marvelous sporting event. Because of the loss, Howard realized that Goodman was out. And they decided to try their plan B choice, Wolf. It took a lot of hard work, but the EGT was finally done, featuring such talents as Igor, Toad, Greaser Boss, and the boys, and of course, Fitzsimons, the D-biscuit trainer. After Goodman was fired, they finally took Red's advice and decided to hire George Wolf. He won them a whole bunch of races and a whole lot of money.
Oh, how about our 1v1 riddle? You know?
No.
Oh, okay. Boop. Eh? So I told the radio station this was happening, and I think everyone's on board. So, see you on the track.
Only if you give me $100,000.
Deal.
How are you doing today?
Are your legs feeling any better, boys?
I can feel my legs. I can feel my legs.
Oh, wait.
This is great. Here's your bill.
$1 million.
And finally, Red was up and ready to race for the War Admiral Seabiscuit race. The race of all races. This is Channel 5 covering the most epic race in history, Seabiscuit versus War Admiral. As they're going, Seabiscuit takes an immediate lead. Red Pollard back on the driver's seat. Saddle. He's up front. Sustaining a decent lead. War Admiral's coming back a little bit. Yeah, but it looks like Seabiscuit's got a healthy lead. Very healthy lead on War Admiral. Oh, but War Admiral is catching back up. Catching back up. Starting to, they're neck and neck right now. Neck and neck, that's for sure. Sticking like that. Like butter. Butter and glue. Alright, but it looks like Seabiscuit still has the lead here. I do not think Seabiscuit's actually lost the lead yet. Excitement in the crowd right now. Seabiscuit is continuing to be in the lead on the home stretch. He's up by several lengths, and looks like Seabiscuit's going for the win here. Looks like Seabiscuit's the winner here. Not the most eventful race ever. I would say, pretty much an annihilation. You're about to hear from our anchors now, back at the studio.
That was an uneventful race for how much hype there was for the War Admiral Seabiscuit bits.
I would say so, Bob.
I would say it was almost disappointingly bad.
But hey, Seabiscuit won.
Did it live up to the hype?
No, not even close. It was off.
I'm just going to stop you right there, Bob. Was it a waste of covering this race so much and wasting so much time?
Definitely. It was garbage. It was absolute garbage.
That was exactly the opposite of what I said. But let me just stop you right there. I would agree. The race is borderline the most terrible race I have ever seen in all of my days as a new sketcher. In fact, it was so bad on a rating 1 to 10. I wouldn't say it was bad. So much as just a monstrous waste of time. Like,
it's time.
Go.
It's time to go, Toad.
Get going, Mom.
Don't dead!
No, not my toe!
Oh, toe!
Haha, wanna race?
Yo, a joust!
death of Toad is your fault, Charles. It's only you to blame. He never loved you anyways. He cheated on you. With your ex-wife.
That demon kid, you got put down!
No!
To get to this one. Now some of you might still be in that place. If you're trying to get out, just follow me. I'll get you. You can try and read my lyrics off of this paper before I lay them, but you won't take this thing out these words before I say them. Cause ain't no way I'm gonna let you stop me from causing mayhem. When I say I'm gonna do something, I do it. I don't give a damn.
Censored.
I'm doing this for me, so
censored.
Just cast up if you think it's stopping me. I'm gonna be what I set out to be, without a doubt, undoubtedly. And all those who look down on me, I'm tearing down your balcony. No way fans are blessed, don't try to ask him why or how can he. From infinite down to the last relapse, I will be
censored.
Salary paid hourly until he passed.
Censored.
Comes first, for better or worse. He's married to the gang.
Censored.
All of the greasers?
Censored.
Where was there a gas leak? My tank? My tank was leaking? Oh, yeah. Yeah, because throwing lit cigarettes on the floor was ever a safety hazard. You're a dog. Bark, bark, indeed, my friend. Bark, bark, indeed.
Goody. Goody.
He died. He said, "Mate,
I guess he was right."
To be on the stars now, he was too young. I was going to be the one to die first, but I outlived him. I was in my chair eating pudding while my horse died of a heart attack. No, I'm sorry. He was my horse. My horse.
You